so much. Would Swamiji have some time for questions?
Yeah, I have. Please.
If the panelists want to go first, or there's some questions in the chat box. Haryana?
Akka wanted to ask.
Yes. Akka? Akka has typed the question. Does she want to say it aloud? Or?
Please say aloud if you can open the...
I can read it out for Swamiji. Swamiji, Vijayalakshmi Akka is asking, many state governments are attempting to divest temples of property and wealth. And I just read that Uttarakhand government is attempting to take over running of all the 51 shrines. Please, can you intervene? We don't want a secular government to interfere in our dharma.
Share with you when this was in a main agenda, Kashmir and CA and all that, we had this as the next issue. Okay, we were to talk and discuss, but suddenly the corona issue delayed it. I certainly want to intervene, and Vijayalakshmi for putting pressure on me. I will follow it up right from today. Okay, we have done some homework and we are working on it, but I will push forward. We have to intervene, not can be, but we have to do this. And we will do this.
Thank you so much. Another question, Swamiji, is how do we inculcate Sanatanis to be less emotional and be more patient? Our society, especially on social media, the reactions are very bipolar, as Swamiji had already said.
Very bipolar. And then there is no Yada talking. They just went to whatever they feel like. Therefore, I keep telling that trust these fellows. The person who are ruling, as I said, जब तक नियत का सवाल है हिंदी में कहते हैं जब तक निष्ठा राष्ट्र निष्ठा धर्म निष्ठा का सवाल है वो 100% से भी ज्यादा है कैसे डिलीवर करना कब डिलीवर करना वो करेंगे बिकॉज उनको अपने से ज्यादा पता है बिकॉज ऑनेस्टली जो मैंने कल्पना भी नहीं की थी और सम ऑफ द स्टोरीज आई नो हाउ दे डिड इट और मोदी जी ने ऐसे दे दिया जैसे गोल्डन प्लेट पे दे दिया हमें जो असंभव बातें थी तो वो करेंगे प्रकार से जैसे चाहे योगी जी हो आप देखिए वहां पे कोरोना रहे योगी जी फिर भी आवाज नहीं उठी है तबलीगी वगैरह की किसी ने चिल्लाया नहीं है थोड़ा हमें उनको समय देना वो उनकी इच्छा के बारे में जरा दिखना चाहिए और वी हैव टू सी दिस फैक्ट ऑल्सो पॉलिटिक्स डायनेमिक्स आर डिफरेंट पीपल डोंट नो सोशल लाइफ में भी डायनेमिक्स आर डिफरेंट इट इज नॉट ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट सो थोड़ा दैट अवेयरनेस इफ यू कैन क्रिएट देन पीपल लर्न टू बी पेशेंट
Thank you, Swamiji. One more question is, how do we maintain our dharma when the system is against it? And what are the insights in performing our duties and actions while being rooted in the self?
Well, while being rooted in a self, you have no duty. I think you have not understood the self. But then if you remain rooted in dharma, you will get rooted in self. See, this is always there. You can't say okay, the situation is against us and the laws are against you. You have to do. First of all, have a conviction that I want to do. And have a trust in yourself. Atma Shraddha. See, there are fourfold Shraddhas. I mean, Ishvara Shraddha, Shastra Shraddha, Guru Shraddha, and Atma. Bhagavan says in 6th chapter, Na Atmanam Avasadaya. Atmaiva Atmano Banduhu, Atmaiva Ripuratman, etc. Have Shraddha on herself. I want to do and I will do. Come what? It's okay. If the result may not come as soon as I want, but I am committed to do. That is the first one. One needs to have and start doing. Secondly, if you are not a leader, not a dharmacharya, or not leading some group or something, then support such institutions from, with your all resources, financial resources, physical resources, cognitive resources, developing soft media or etc., whatever you can support. And you see, certain things only vastas can do, certain things only acharyas can do. Organizational work, using your context. And I tell you, our dharma is so rich and so glorious and so logical. Quite a few youngsters or generation is turned away because of ignorance. You need a proper unfoldment. Connect this to a proper person who knows how to deliver, and that group, they are not bad as we think. I find modern generation is much better than my generation. Only thing is, they are not aware about it. And the media till today somehow anti-Hindu. First time I was so happy to see this. First time whole media, entire media call a spade as a spade when this public issue came. I stood up to them. I don't know, that's a grace or something, whatever it is. But then media projected us differently. They have misconceptions. Acharyas, and you have this commitment. You can be in dharma, and as far as the abiding in the self is concerned, form a habit of swadhyaya. Have a quality time for yourself. Daily, minimum 1 hour, you sit. Now, this is these are our opportunities that you get all electronic media and YouTube and all things available. So sit at home, keep the picture of a teacher, and then study.
Thank you, Swamiji. One of them says that indeed Modi ji has delivered unimaginable results. What is Swamiji's view on the introduction of a dharmic education policy soon?
Well, it is impossible, let me be honest, because in the secular state, it will not stand in the law. Next day, court will dismiss it and we'll have not a good face to show. At least, if you can do this, listen this carefully. You don't need government to introduce dharmic education. Private schools are more than government schools in terms of quality and some areas quantity-wise. People, because of this WTO, where they have put the education into business category, people have invested lots of money in education, either for profit or out of drive, self-drive, that I want to contribute something to society and give a best school, etc. Contact them and introduce to them. Why you? We want government. And these are, and I tell you, most of these policy makers of the generation next, most of the business leaders of the generation next are going to come from these private schools, not government schools. I'm not talking ill of them or those boys and things, but then these few guys have more exposures, more chances for them. There will be quite a bit percentage of this people, decision makers and policy makers from this area. Let's work on them and introduce dharmic education. And I tell you, more than dharma, really starts with values at least.
Values.
Basic values are missing. You need not teach Gita to children. Just remember values and give some value for Gita. But at least Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, this, we live a joint family, Vasudeva Kutumbakam. The whole village was a family. That kind of values, rather than self-centered, give some values that will help the country. Then you can slowly proceed to dharma forms and spirituality.
Thank you, Swamiji. Do any of the panelists have questions for Swamiji? Because there's one or two common questions about temple resources being managed by Hindu Sanatanis, also about demographics, how it's reducing among Hindus and increasing among other communities. These are the questions that are there in the chat box, unless panelists have some other questions. Ravi Garu or Hari Garu?
Yeah, Swamiji, Namaste, Hari Om. I live in Silicon Valley, Swamiji. And, you know, one of the ideas that really sort of inspired us to have this festival is to really create awareness and also curiosity. Because I've always sort of grown up with the idea that Adi Shankara is probably one of the best entrepreneurs, one of the best, you know, CEOs, leaders. So this festival was our first step to create sort of massive awareness. So what would you recommend? So we have big plans. We would like at least 1 billion people to know this concept of oneness, because our philosophy is the only one that unites the world, which is what is needed now. So what would you recommend? What should we do next after this festival?
Join us. I have a big plan. We had planned one big conference in Vignan Bhavan, international one, and with a big bank. See, let's talk from some Vyavara point of view. The yoga has become Bharat's soft power. Now, it's not proper to say, but this is a fact, Corona is an opportunity to position our Ayurveda. You can create a soft power in terms of Ayurveda. Government has given sanction for research, by the way. There is HRD ministry has issued a circular. Ayurvedic people can do clinical research along with allopathic administration. So work on that. We can position Ayurveda. Ayush Ministry has issued. Should you want that GR, I'll send you. I have that circular. So all those who have Ayurvedic college, ask them to go and make agreement to government hospitals and do research. And what is that? See, we say Tulsi helps and this helps and that helps. But then we have to document it. You know, Narendra Bhai said in one of his earlier talks when he talked to public, I call upon the youth to put this in a way they become acceptable. So we have to document it and put it in this way, thereby Ayurveda becomes acceptable. One. Secondly, this vision of oneness itself is the greatest soft power India can offer to the world. Because we are inclusive. They talk of exclusivity. If you come to us, then only you will have salvation or heaven, visa for heaven. The visa is granted on the basis of belief, not your karmas. That's what that thinking is. So we can fufu all this with this vision of oneness. And so this we have to take further globally. And to make it global, we have to position Shankaracharya ji at national level. We have had in between a meeting, our Hari knows, in Bangalore, we were contemplating on Bharat Yatra, like Vishwamangal Gorogram Yatra, and it's a 3-year project we had planned out, long drawn. And then first of all, we have to create awareness among Hindus, you know. It's so unfortunate, these gurus, you know, both gurus, Astika gurus and Nastika gurus, who talk some yoga chamcha, all gurudevs, modern gurudevs. Their birthday, you get millions of people. Shankar Jayanti, nobody knows. Gita Jayanti, nobody knows, except we few who studied. So we have to create first our awareness in India, position Shankaracharya properly, and then take him to global. Working on it, I will invite you and guys in next meeting once this is over. We have few plans, and then few conferences also we have planned that, you see, we have to put, our dharma is considered to be primitive, pagan and all, they have conditioned that way. So we have to get this. Recently I did a trial run, you know, laboratory experiment. I had a scientist and religious leader in my ashram conference from Indian Institute of Science and Defense and then universities. And so I plan to have some big names, scientists. They should tell, no, this is great. Then our youth will believe. Like Bhagavan telling to Kaunt, Arjuna, Kaunteya pratijani hi name bhakta pranasati. You take a law that my bhakta never perish. If I tell, people think that I am marketing myself. But you are a shreshta. You say this. Similarly, we have to make them say. That is one of the project I am going to restart. And I had a plan for Bangalore in June. Then it, because of this, got delayed. So we'll talk with you and Hari in future. Once this is over, we'll pick up the thread. And thanks that in Madhya Pradesh, Shivraj Singh Ji is back. He worked a lot. Acharya Sabha pushed for Shankaracharya Memorial there. Mm-hmm. And I think it was our idea we gave him that there was a huge yatra. My God, excellent work, excellent work. I myself was a party to one of the four yatra. I gave 1 month. And then every village, government, Rajyashraya, MLA, MP, and then the welcome, and then Kalashas, and 108-foot tall statue of Shankaracharya. Just awareness, at least people should know there is Shankaracharya. And we got the land and then got it out from forest department at Omkareshwara. And we are pushing it from the behind, as usual, face in the crowd. And then the Bhumi Pujan was done, and then we wanted to make a like memorial, was audio video like Swami Narayan and our Gandhinagar, Mahatma Gandhi Mandir type. And then he lost the power. Now, thank God he's back. And he himself is driven. So, Omkareshwar. Anybody goes there will remember at least Shankaracharya. And then awareness nation-wise we have to get. And take support of these governments where they appreciate Hindu sentiments. And then create awareness in public in general.
Excellent, Swamiji. I think I'm just thinking, you know, having been in the U.S. for the last 30 years, any day celebrated in the U.S., automatically becomes popular, like the Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, Father's Day. So Harigaru, I think we should announce something called as the World Oneness Day on Adi Shankar Jayanti. Start in the US and Indians will probably follow. Because that's the trend we see in many other sort of activities.
True. But then you have to fix a date, like what we did for yoga, you know, the solstice. We started with that. And way back in 2009 or something, I had that conference because yoga was being hijacked. Christ yoga and wrinkle yoga were coming, Mary yoga. So we just put this, we had a conference in Sri Sri, kept the Sri Sri, and then Vikesh Iyengar and Ramdev and all of them were brought together and then declare and blah, blah, blah. To do that strategically. But you have to fix one fixed day because we Shankaracharya Jayanti is on lunar calendar.
Yes.
Tithi, you know.
Definitely, Swamiji.
Our idea for this Vigyan Bhavan conference was declaration of Oneness Day.
Yeah.
Bang. See, don't think small. Think big.
Yes.
And then one yatra or one place, it doesn't carry. You have to think big and execute big. Then when you like Reliance Jio, you know, come with a big. Then you have some 8 crores customers. Otherwise, so many companies didn't go forward. So we had a plan, get all dignitaries at Vignan. First yatra all over India and then at Vignan Bhavan. And then declare. And demand. Like Gita Jayanti, we have started.
Hmm.
Of our acharyas helped us, and then Haryana celebrates Gita Jayanti every year.
Hmm.
We did it on Lal Killa. Gita. Sushma Swaraj came, and then she demanded. Now recently, Mohanji Bhagwat was there in last one. Because we didn't demand a Gita Jayanti day again. Rashtriya Granth, Rashtriya Granth. You have to create ho-ha, ho-ha, public opinion. And then fix a date. Like one corner. Rajyashraya really helps. The whole place, you should see what it was before. What is today. Whole thing has changed. Every Haryana child knows there is Gita Jayanti. Formally, when you say Gita Jayanti, who's Gita? They thought somebody's daughter I'm talking about. Now they know Bhagavad Gita. So, I think we can work on that big conference and then declare in Delhi.
Declare it, yeah.
Thank you for being so optimistic, Swamiji. That
was
wonderful.
Not simply Shankaracharya. You see, one should know. If you go by Shankaracharya, Vallabhas and Ramanujas will alienate.
Oneness.
Mm.
Oneness.
We have to talk Sanatana Dharma. Oneness. Vedas. Put Veda forward. With hidden agenda, you can have our Bhasha, Shankara Bhasha. You talk Vedas and all that. It was hard time to convince Shankaracharya. I put my foot down. They want only Shankaracharya. Only Shankaracharya. I said, it will not. 3-5 days discussion. My God. It's a hot discussion. We had it. I kept on pushing. Still, at least I could convince this one. Now I have to go to Sungeri and talk it out. They think, no, Shankaracharya statue only we will carry. I said, don't carry that. This is emotional issue, you know. India बोलते हैं ना पापड़ बेलने पड़ते दिमाग खाना पड़ता है उधर with all मर्यादा you have to tell them Shankaracharya statue if you carry finished again the fragmentation it will be like Ramanuja Yatra another temple of Shankaracharya what else Hindu Samaj will not get united and then anti Brahmin they have really sold this idea in Tamil Nadu The Shankaracharya means Brahmanas. The Dalit will go away. You have to talk of Sanatana, Sarve, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam and blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Like but then Murli Manohar Joshi, hidden agenda, that is okay. That's a strategy we should have.
Yes, Swamiji. That was very brilliant and very impassionate.
Thank you so much, Swamiji.
When you come and see me, we'll discuss some of the ideas. We had have about almost 15-20 meetings. Working group is working. And few people are involved in it. So we can discuss personally.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.
Namaste. Shri
Guru.
Thank you, Swamiji, for that very bold, brilliant, and impassionate discourse and talk and discussion with us. Our next and last session, the grand finale, will be at 6:15 p.m. IST with closing remarks by the founder of Indic Academy, Sri Harikiran Garu, followed by a dance performance, Advaita in performance by Rukmini Vijay Kumarji, and a live discourse in Telugu with English summary on the expedience of Adi Shankara for humanity. By Brahmashri Samavedam Shanmukha Sarmagaru. And we end this 1 month long Oneness Festival with a vote of thanks by Sri Ravishankar Garu. Please do join us. Sri Guru Bhyo Namah.